Right. Right. Shorthand dictation, Karnataka, November 1971, 80 words per minute, 10 minutes speed. Now write down. Gentlemen, I have great pleasure in welcoming you all to this 10th annual general body meeting of the shareholders of this company. The printed copies of the report of the board of directors and the accounts of the company for the year ended 30th June 1971 are in your hands, and I shall, with your kind permission, take them as read. Since our last meeting, there have been some change in the board of directors. Two directors who rendered valuable service have retired, and in their place two other young and enthusiastic gentlemen have come on the board. Your directors have placed on record their high appreciation of the valuable services rendered by those who retired and have extended a hearty welcome to the new directors who have come in their place. I think you have observed from the annual report that the company has continued to make steady progress. The working results show a continued trend of higher profits. The gross earnings have increased and the expenditure has come down. We have therefore made adequate profits, and there is no need to approach the state government for any kind of financial help. Since its inception, the company worked in a small rented building. With the growth of business, the premises was found not sufficient and unsuitable. Your directors felt that a stage had reached when the company should have its own building. Accordingly, this spacious premises where this meeting is being held was got constructed, and our office was shifted to it. The progress of the company and of its working are to be judged not merely by the gross earnings and net profits, but also by its usefulness to the society as a whole. While we have yet to go a long way before we can claim to have achieved our objectives, I am happy to be able to say that the company has taken a few steps in that direction with fair success. Last year, there was significant development in your company, which brought up many problems. There has been marked changes in the attitudes and the moods of our people. This was perhaps inevitable in the context of the developments in the fields of science and technology. Our people, and particularly our young people, are now exposed to all ideas and thoughts of the world. There is a marked desire and urge for better life. There can, however, be no real progress without hard work and production of more and better goods and services. While there has been good progress in many fields, there is still a wide gap between the developed and the developing nations. There is, however, no cause for pessimism, and we can look forward with confidence and faith in the ability of our people to achieve an honored place in the world. We in our company are pledged to do our best in the field of development of this state. We look forward to coming years with confidence and hope of greater service. Before I conclude, I would like to express on behalf of the directors and myself our grateful appreciation and thanks to all those who made it possible for us to achieve another year of successful working. I take this opportunity to express my sincere and grateful thanks to my friends and the board for their keen interest. Dear friend, your letter gave me a pleasure, surprise indeed. I had not heard from you for the past 3 years, and I was thinking as to whether you were in the same station or transferred. Now I am glad to learn that you were on deputation and have returned to your old place with good training and experience. You have inquired as to whether the Dasara festivities this year would be in the usual strain and whether you could come with your family and remain with me. I need not particularly say that you and your family are always welcome, and your program to come during Dasara is all the more pleasant. I am told that this year Dasara functions will take place better than what they were in the past year or two. The government is taking very keen interest in promotion tourism, and in that behalf they have decided to spend a large amount to make this function a grand success. Of course, there will be the usual cultural activities and the exhibition in addition to the procession. The city will be full of life during the above period, and people from all parts of the country come to enjoy the entertainments as well as the fine climate. as you say, you have not witnessed the Dasara before. Please do come with your people to Mysore. I will certainly make all the necessary arrangements. Yours sincerely.